I received this Westclox alarm clock the other day. It belongs to David from Canada. A nice polished brass bezel. Up to now, all these I have seen have been nickel-plated. It's a 1926 style 1A Big Ben alarm clock. It's got a couple of dents on the bezel. There's signs of clear coat on the case. Copper plating under the nickel plating is showing through. These dark areas showing through is the underlying steel that has oxidized. Here's a run in the clear coat that has been applied over the entire surface. Some crud that was clear coated over. Remains of nickel plating on this winding knob. More remains of nickel plating. Nickel plating is missing from this brass knob. The darkness on this knob is oxidized brass, just a small piece of nickel plating left in the center on it. Nickel plating mostly gone. Lift this back off. The inside has been clear coated. This black stuff, it's excess buffing compound residue. Someone has buffed this case and didn't bother to clean up their mess. Clear coat applied over rust, buffing compound deposits. A caked on mess. It's going to need to be scraped off and cleaned. This compound is an abrasive. Every time the alarm goes off, this stuff will be shaking loose and getting in the movement. inner case has been buffed and clear coated. These dark areas are rust. Not sure what this reddish residue is. It's been clear coated over. Remains of nickel plating. And the bow has some nickel plating left on it. Dark spots is oxidized brass, where the clear coat is failing. Dial is aged and has some rust stains on it. Minute hand is fairly loose, so it'll pop off easy. More excess buffing compound. Clear coat over the rust. Zinc plating is starting to fail on the dial pan. Owner says it won't keep running anymore. This balance wheel doesn't have any end shake. Might be one of the reasons it keeps stopping. A small amount of pressure on the plates, and it stops the balance wheel. This is why these need end shake on the balance wheel. A lot of dirt, hairs, and lint. This black stuff around the pivots might have some of the buffing compound mixed in it. I'll need to pre-clean it before I can inspect for wear. This dark spot on the corner is a fingerprint left years ago. Lots of dust and lint on this movement. Remove this balance wheel first. To loosen the cone bearing, I'll use this set of nut spinners, made by Moody of Rhode Island. Not sure if they're even in business anymore. Oil on the balance staff pivots is completely dried. When these were new, they were serviced every couple of years. let the mainsprings down. Before I remove the cannon pinion, I'll check the thrust clearance. Looks like 10 thousandths. Brass hammer so it doesn't leave tool marks on the center shaft. clutch action on the center wheel is good. I've pre-cleaned the movement. Now I can inspect for wear. Looks like this movement is going to need several bushings. File the egg-shaped hole so it's round and concentric. Now to ream it through. I fabricate most of my own bushings on the lathe from a 360 brass rod. Press the bushing in. These pin vices have removable chucks in them. When the nut is tightened, the split chuck grips the brooch. This brooch fits the pivot just fine. These particular brooches are small and fragile, so I use very light pressure or they'll break. Nice, the pivot fits snug. Ready for a smoothing brooch. Needles work excellent for smoothing brooches. I'll need one close to the same size of the pivot. This should work good with no binding. Now to deburr the bushing. This is a set of deburring tools. This bushing needs a real small one. Doesn't take much pressure. Use the air bellow to check the freedom of the pivots. Spins nice and free. All the bushings are installed and the wheels mesh together nice. Movement has been final cleaned. Time to reassemble. just a small drop of oil on the balance staff cone bearings. Nice. Two complete winds and the balance wheel is in motion. It's been 2 weeks and it's been running non-stop.